Hello and welcome everyone to another NASCAR Racing 2003 live stream. How are you all doing today? Let me figure out what is going on there. There we go. How is everyone doing? Let me turn that off. Sorry guys. Slow start. Wasn't quite prepared for this one. Alright, I think we're all set up. Thank you very much for joining me for the stream today. Right off the bat, if you guys could please like the video. Thanks to all you subscribers and you followers. Check out my Facebook page. That is it. Thank you guys again for joining. As you can see by the title of today's stream, I'm going to be doing part two, trying to recreate Ricky Rudd's infamous 1984 Daytona wreck, where he had the bad tumble coming into the infield, into the tri-oval. Why is the stream not loading on my laptop? But it is coming through. So I will stop procrastinating and jump on in. Alright, Jesus, we're already a few minutes in. Alright, let's go to player info. Here we got his number 15 car. If you guys want to see the replay of the wreck, either just YouTube, Ricky Rudd, Flip, Daytona Crash, etc., etc., or check out part one to my Can I Recreate video. And so we're going to be using the Grand National Daytona 1970. Same as last time, I'm assuming at some point I'm going to have to exit out of the game into the track INI file so you guys will see the settings then at the 1984 roster. One difference between this part and part one of trying to do this wreck, I was using the CTS physics version of the Aero 88 mod. And I'm using Cup this time, so hopefully I should be going faster. And I did a few tests earlier before the stream started, tweaking the track settings. So hopefully we're somewhere close. As you can see, I have the track temperature down to a negative 110. Have the grip around 1.5. Have restrictor plates on, even though there weren't restrictor plates at this point. But I have the chassis type at 4. In the INI file, I'm trying to think of what else. Oh yeah, and the grass grip. I have track grass grip set to 10 to try to help me dig in once I come down from being airborne. I have direction pad up, left, down, right for first, second, third, and fourth gear. I'm shifting manually, and I have it that way because when I get up to speed, coming out of turn four, I'm going to downshift either first or reverse directly, whichever works better, to try to replicate that spin of him losing control coming out of the turn. And hopefully that's everything to bring you guys up to speed. No pun intended. If I'm remembering correctly, he was behind a small line of cars in the replay. How's it going? Productions. These guys pass me. Alright. Try to get up to around 205, 210. Alright, right around here is when he loses it. Come on. Oh. Yep, you can see what the heightened grass grip does right there. It makes you dig in the second you get sideways. So that, the grass grip is set to 10. Maybe I need to turn it down just a little bit. Alright, I think I needed to do it a little bit sooner, and I needed to be going faster, obviously. And yeah, I'll probably need to turn the grass grip down at some point, but we'll try another one. Keep it under 45. I'm gonna restart the session so there's not a bunch of tire marks from the last one. My stream keeps pausing on my laptop. Alright, but it's coming through on here. I'm just paranoid that the stream isn't working, but it seems to be coming through fine. Just not showing up on my laptop for some reason. this line of cars behind me, past me, right now, so I can get good drafting speed off them. Whoa, nice lost control there. Aha, it's coming through now. Alrighty, so... Well, that didn't work out the way I wanted it to. It was a cool wreck, though. That would have been kind of good if I was going for Trevor Boy's 1984 flip. At least the start of it. I flipped one too many times for that. The stream is running smoothly, alright, good. Now I can focus on attempt number three, numero tres. If only I could roll my R's. That's one thing I was never able to do. Roll my R's. Speaking of Trevor Boys, come on. Oh, damn it. He actually hit that. He actually hit the inside wall. See, that's why the first two times I was kind of staying towards the outside of the track and then hitting it, or hitting the first gear to spin towards the inside, because if I was too close to the inside of the track to start with, I kept hitting the inside wall on the tests I was doing, like I just did there. I think the sparks coming out from my car. Man. Alright, so a couple more tries and I will adjust the track settings accordingly. Oops. I have to restart this. Don't want a bunch of tire marks from the blatant previous attempts. Sorry, productions. We're dropping frames right now. Just hang in there. It should end shortly. Whenever I've been dropping frames recently, it doesn't last too long. And you can always check out the full video on YouTube, completely uninterrupted by any connection or interference issues. There's nothing I can do about the Twitch issues right now. So keep hanging in there. I appreciate you staying around and watching. Jesus. Your right front tire is wearing out. That was a hard wreck. That was quite interesting. Alright, one more time and I'm going to turn the track grass grip down just a little bit. So we are up to 3,000 drop frames. Go away. Oh my god. Alright, so I guess this part's for solely for the ones on YouTube watching this right now. God damn it. That's what happens when you look away from the computer screen to look at the preview. That was a cool wreck. God damn it, though. What the fuck is going on with the stream? This is what it's doing. It's 3 seconds and then pauses. 3 seconds and pauses. 3 seconds and pauses. Ugh, this is getting fucking annoying. I want to see a replay of that wreck, though. Again. Into Lake Lloyd. What the fuck is going on? 12,000 drop frames. Check this out, everybody. Or no, not 12,000. 5,000. If any tech experts can tell me why this is happening, even though our internet is perfect and I have the Twitch settings set exactly to what I should have for our upload and download speed, if anyone can tell me why that's happening, I would love to hear, but until then I'm convinced Twitch is trying to fuck me over. They're intentionally trying to sabotage me. There's no convincing me otherwise. And hey, it ended. Alright, window cap. Need to go to the track folder. Here we are in Daytona GN70. Try refreshing the page now. Alright, so here's what we got the settings at. Chassis type 4. Here's the asphalt and concrete grip. That's what we have that set at. I want to turn this down a little bit. Try like 8. Save. And this is at -100. I kind of like where that is. Let's actually try down a little bit more. I want to get airborne a bit easier. Boom. Load the game back up. Alright, seems we stopped at 6,300 dropped frames. I never had that type of issue when I was doing this to YouTube. Never. I had some dropped frames here or there, never thousands and thousands and thousands at a time. And I have the settings right for what it should be for Twitch, but it keeps happening, so I'd love to hear any suggestions as to why it's happening. Alright, let's go back in. Do I have... it's the window switched over? No, but the comments aren't. There they are. It's fine now, yeah. I wonder if it has anything to do with... because it stopped once I quit out of the game, or if that was just a coincidence. Alright, let's see if turning the grass grip down made any difference. No, I think it's just a matter of just trying enough times. So I think the settings are getting close to what they should be. I'm getting airborne about the right amount of time. Going about the right speed, give or take like 10 or 15 miles an hour. I'm spinning out in about the right area. Just a matter of getting the luck to get the flip right. Get behind these cars. Trying first.
Limit 70. Keep it under 4,500 in second.
That was an interesting ride. Oh, close. Almost got hit by a bunch of other cars. I think I waited a little bit too long for that one. I'm gonna try reverse next time. Because that was first gear. The spin didn't seem as right, and I've been doing reverse.
Don't go over there. Keep it under 4,500 in a second. Watch that speed now. Keep it under 4,500 in a second. Okay, you're clear of pit lane.
Alright, I'm gonna wait for those. Cars 4 seconds back. So I need a small group of cars in front of me. I'm going to get the rec right, I want the AI layout to be a little bit correct. I have a little bit amount of cars around me. A little bit amount of cars. Just a little. Get in front of me. Sneva. See, I went too close to the inside. I need to just barely miss it like he did in real life. Because he got damn close to the entrance to the pit wall. The pit wall. Pit road. Wall entrance. Blah, blah. In real life. Next. Jesus, I can't talk tonight. Waiting for this line of cars behind me so I can get behind them. Try to get close to the infield, but not close enough to where I hit the pit wall.
Limit 70.
Hit the pit wall again.
Your right bunker is wearing out.
Oh, that was a hard wreck.
You got one stopped up ahead.
Next.
Keep it under 4,500
in these other two cars pass me. Good feeling about this one. Good vibes, good vibes.
Minute 70, keep it under 4,500 in second.
Damn it. Damn it. I keep hitting that entrance, that pit wall. What do I need to do differently? What do I need to do differently? Closest I've gotten yet, but I just barely clipped that wall. thumbnail. It's definitely the closest I've gotten yet. Are you ready? Okay. I'll be right back. I gotta go grab some water. Back. Braden, how's it going? Alright. Next. Alright, so I think I'm starting to get the right idea as to where I need to spin to get right next close to that pit road wall, but not actually hit it. Cars 7 seconds back. I'm tucking behind that line. 4, 3. Shoot. Forgot I was in the. My directional pad shifting mode. I'm hitting the paddle shifters. I think reverse works best. Shoot.
Don't go over 70. Keep it under 4,500 in second.
Nope. The start of the flip wasn't right. And yeah, I didn't like how that started either. I think I waited a little too long. Yeah, because I could have started tumbling in that grass right before pit road, but I just waited maybe a half second too long to spin that time. Next. I think I'm getting the right settings, though. God damn it. Hold on. Phone alarm kept going off.
Limit 7. Keep it under 4,500 in second. Watch that speed down. Keep it under 4,500 in second. Okay, you're
clear. Sweet. I got a line of cars about 2 seconds behind me. Perfect. Merge up with them. Perfect. .230, that's not excessive at all.
Limit 70. Keep it under 4,500 in second.
Damn it. I hit the... Whoa. Jesus. Well, I think that takes the cake for the worst wreck I've had so far this stream. Danny Bagwell, that one actually might be fairly easy. So obviously I'm not going to get all the parts of the car to fly off, and no one really knows how that one started. Camera kind of cuts in halfway through the wreck. Alright, yeah, this is a brutal one. Maybe I need to be going a tad slower for the start of that. Jesus. That 35 took a hard hit. Who was that? I honestly do not know who that is. Boom. Alrighty, next attempt. We're dropping frames again, aren't we? Nope. Maybe just for a second. What's going on with the stream? Oh no, I think my laptop just froze. Let's see. Nope. What the hell is going on? Is anyone else experiencing issues? Alright, no more issues. Alright, good.
Don't go over 70. Keep it under 4,500.
Do you know what that kind of looked like? That was almost like Randy LaJoy's around the same time when he nailed the inside wall. AJ Foyt, 1965 Flip Riverside. I'm going to have to decline that one for two reasons. One, I've already looked into it, and the only versions of Riverside I can find, there's no part of the infield in that last turn where it drops down to even make that wreck possible. And two, he was so seriously badly injured in that wreck, he technically died, but they revived him. So I'm going to put that one in the category of no due to fatality or serious injury. But yeah, that, alright. On with the replay. Yeah, that looks like Randy LaJoy's. Kind of. He never actually technically flipped back over once he hit the wall, and he went a little bit too far. That was similar. No, I mean he technically died. I mean his heart stopped and they revived him multiple times. Yeah, he lived, but technically his heart stopped. If my research is correct from that wreck. Like multiple times, but then they revived him. Yeah, I didn't mean he died. I mean he died technically, medically speaking, just for like a few minutes or a few moments before they revived him several times. Because, yeah, he basically took a 30-foot drop from wherever that car landed and basically took the entire brunt of the impact with his spine since there was no safety features back then. Basically, yeah, he had broken vertebrae. No, I'm not too sure on that. That one was a lot more like Randy LaJoy's, except he flipped it a few too many times there. I need to stop hitting the inside pit wall. Need to figure out how to spin to get near it, but not actually hit it. That is the tricky part.
Don't go over there. Keep it under 4,500. Watch that speed now. Keep it on 4,500.
Okay, Yeah, I meant to say, I'm not sure if he broke his spine or not. I'd imagine with how that car landed. But I know he was seriously injured. I'm not sure if that was one of his injuries or not. So don't quote me on that. I'm going to slow down just a tad right before I hit reverse. Ah, damn it.
You blew a tire. Watch that speed now. Keep it on 4,500.
World's best save. Who needs your front left tire on a super speedway? Anyway. Randy LaJoy 1999 flip. I also have that one on my to-do list. Alright, come on, cars. I need to get behind you. There we go. Alright, does anyone have any suggestions as to what I'm doing wrong for this one? Keep recreating Randy LaJoy's wreck. And someone just blew an engine right there, number 14. Don't apologize. Not many people knew that, and that wasn't technically a fatality, so it's not bluntly disrespectful. And yeah, it's a little-known fact that he was actually technically killed in that, but revived. I didn't know that until recently when doing my research on trying to reenact that flip, and that flip itself. So yeah, if I wasn't trying to look that up in the first place, I wouldn't have known that either. Alright, waiting for these cars 5 seconds back. Shoot. Didn't mean to get on the grass. Try spinning a little earlier. Alright, I will try that.
Limit 70. Keep it under 4,500 in seconds. You all right? It's over. We can't fix that damage.
Damn, that was a hell of a way to pull up to a pit stop.
We got big time problems with that motor, buddy.
I don't know if this, I'm not sure if this grass right here is affected by me adjusting the grass grip, because it doesn't feel like I'm digging in this grass like I am right here. No, not cancel. I need to try a better attempt that time.
Over 70. Keep it under 4,500.
How long has this been going on anyway? Alright. Yeah, I wasn't going fast enough that time to even get airborne. Come on. I have a good feeling about this one. Oops.
Limit 70. Keep it under 45 in seconds.
Same thing. Just nailed the inside wall. I think I'll try slowing down just a little bit. Try spinning in the same spot, but slowing down just a little bit and slamming on the brakes immediately when I start spinning. So I need to get the back end up in the air, but not all the way over. I don't know if I'd call that pit stop a save, because I technically ruined my engine and smashed the front of the car before I got to the pits, but... Alright, pass me, you dumbass. There we go. If anyone has any suggestions of what they might think I need to change settings-wise or anything else...
Limit 70. Keep it under
4500. Oh, damn it. Try doing what I was doing earlier in the stream and kind of turn right a little bit right before I spin, so the momentum of me spinning doesn't carry me as far to the inside of the track, if you know what I mean. Kind of get a little turn to the left going on, or to the right going on first. What is everyone doing? Yeah, I don't think that grass before pit entrance has the same effect. I think that time I needed to be going a little bit faster, though. Because I spun out in about the right path. I wasn't going fast enough to get airborne. Same thing as last time, but be going a little bit faster.
Limit 70. Keep it under 4500.
Does that count? God damn it. Getting closer. I think I'm onto something with the turning right before I, or kind of ever so slightly drifting right before I spin around to the left. I think I'm onto something with that.
Okay, you're clear of pit lane. Okay, merge when you can. limit 70. Keep it under 4,500 in seconds.
Nope. More Randy LaJoy. Wow. So if I ever try Randy LaJoy's, that one's going to be easy. I know all the settings I need to do. No, not exit. I don't think speed's the issue. I think it's still just a matter of spinning at the right angle to where I get really close to the pit wall but not actually hitting it. And I need to dig into the grass right before I get to the pavement of pit road. So I start the tumbling right before that. Be going fast enough to get airborne and dig in, but not so fast to where I go all the way to the inside of the track. Shortly after coming off the turn, I'm going to do the right, right, and then looking good. Oh, damn it. Alright, that path where I spun and started to flip was a lot closer to what I'm... I'm not quite sure if I have the Randy LaJoy car. I'm like 95% sure I have it, but I'll have to look into that. But yeah, I will do that one at some point. Next pack of cars behind me, or in front of me, I should say. Alright, so I'm definitely onto something. Except I messed that up. I'm gonna be nowhere near the cars in front of me. And we're dropping frames again. Yeah, the grass grip before pit road is definitely not affected by the settings that I changed. Does anyone know what settings I'd need to do in the track INI to adjust the grip level of the grass before pit road? Because right now I just have track underscore grass underscore grip, then equals, you guys saw it, and then equals 8. Still good. Oh, and it's not. I thought that was just a scratch. God damn it. am I doing wrong? Obviously doing something wrong because I keep making the same mistake. Says grass isn't dangerous. Oh, what am I doing wrong? Someone let me know. This is the closest version I could find to Daytona where the infield is similar. There's not too many versions of Daytona in the 70s and 80s, just a couple. Maybe next time I'll try a different version. This is the closest I could find. Close enough, right? Come on. One of these times I just have to get lucky. Alright, get in front of me, bozos. I think I need to figure out what setting I need to change to adjust the grip in the grass leading up to the pit road right before it.
Don't go over 70. Keep it under 4,500.
God damn it. If I started end over ending and barrel rolling, that could have been decent, but I was just barrel rolling instead, so it doesn't look that good. But alright, I need to see what I did, because that spin and airborne was basically perfect. Like that. If right when he hit the damn pavement, he would have started pirouetting on the nose and shit and spinning around, as opposed to just barrel rolling, that could have been decent. At least I saved what I did, what speed I was going at. I should have looked before I quit out. I saved where I was when I spun, the speed I was going, so at least I have that attempt saved. Another Randy LaJoy. Next. That flip wasn't good. The start of it wasn't perfect, and he just barrel rolled. He needs to do end over ends too, and he flipped too many times. Yeah, he spun at the right spot and flipped, but it wasn't that close. So calm down.
You're too far back. Pull up.
There we go. Dude, why are you freaking out? We're having some dropped frames. Is that why you're freaking out? Yep. I was wondering why you were, like, screaming my fucking name over and over in caps. You need to calm down, dude. Just having some dropped frames on Twitch. It happens. For a minute, some guy needs to scream my name in text form in all caps like 5 times in a minute. Sure, are you okay? I'm fine. You're the one freaking out. Aw, damn it. Talk about a hard hit. Yeah, those of you watching at Twitch were having some dropped frame issues. The way he hit the wall right here, he would have a little bit of a headache. Boom! Still dropping frames, or... No. Nope, we're good now. So we've had 10,000 drop frames total in this stream. It's gotta be a new record. Come on, Buddy Baker. This one.
Don't go over 70. Keep it under
45. Oh, damn it. Damn it, he just clipped that wall. That might have been decent. He just clipped the wall. All right, I need to see. Alright, I was going about 220. And I spun right after that caution marker, basically. Oh, god damn it. That could have been good. That could have been decent. Next. How long has this damn stream been going on? Alright guys, this is probably going to be the third to last attempt. We're already at 57 minutes, holy cow. Alright, now I know how fast I need to be going, where I need to spin, and about what angle I need to spin at. So, hopefully with all those recipes put together, I say all those recipes, all those ingredients put together, hopefully I should have the perfect recipe to get this. Second to last attempt. I really am hoping to not have to do a part three for this one. Damage. I just had a few dropped frames. As many as it seems, it's only been 4% of the entire stream. And if you watch it on YouTube, none of those dropped frames will be dropped on YouTube. They will all be there. All 10,000 of them. Yes, I know you're experiencing lag. Dropped frames, it's nothing new. And until I can go back to YouTube, there's nothing I can do about it. Because Twitch apparently hates me. I have a $1,000 computer, amazing internet speed. My computer's literally right next to our router. I have all my settings perfect for what I should have them be on Twitch. And yet, every now and then, it just wants to drop 10,000 frames on me, so. Anyone wants to tell me what I'm doing wrong, I'd love to hear, but until then, I'm convinced Twitch hates me. Ah, damn it. That was almost way worse. God damn it. Bobby Allison hitting the wall. Alright, this will be the last attempt for this stream. Thank you guys for watching. I apologize to those of you watching on Twitch that experienced that major dropped frames moment there, but if you watch it on YouTube, if you guys are right now, you guys won't be experiencing that. You'll just be seeing me complaining and freaking out and some other guy freaking out while the stream's perfectly fine for you guys. It's one advantage to watching it later on. You guys don't experience any of the internet lag or drop frame interruptions that the people watching live do. You're just watching the nice recorded video file that's recorded on my computer while I'm streaming. Yes, I'll go backwards, buddy. You need to stop typing multiple things in all caps. Don't abuse the chat. It's a privilege. It's not a right. Come on. Oh! Oh, come on! That might have been decent if he didn't hit the damn inside wall. Oh. Of course, the damn last attempt has to be one of the closest. To get my hope up. Get my hopes up. God God damn it. Alright guys, I will go backwards now. To please a certain someone. Just kidding. Ugh. Ugh, fuck. There's only 30 cars though in this set. So I hope that's alright. Damn, I'm just watching the replay of that last attempt. I was so close if I didn't hit that damn inside wall. If I can get every single car involved. Whoa. Alright, see you guys on the other side. Figuratively and literally.
You've been disqualified for reckless driving. Watch that speed now. Keep it on 4,500 in second. Okay, you're clear of pit lane. Don't go over 70. Keep
ah, got that. Official. Did I get everyone? Nope, I missed like two cars. I missed them. There's some that got by. There's some that got by. That official just appearing out of nowhere. Damn. Tim Richmond, Richard Petty. Whoever that 44 is got the worst of it. Alright, that is it for tonight's stream, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please hit the like button. Thank you so much for your support. Post your suggestions down below of what you'd want to do me. Of what you'd want me to do in the future. Oh my god. Ultimate tongue twister moment there. And what your suggestions could be for what I need to do to make this one better. Post your race suggestions, your can I recreate suggestions. Thanks so much for watching. Please hit the like button again. Thanks for all the support. Follow me on Twitch. Just subscribe on YouTube. Go check out my Facebook page. That is it for tonight. Thanks one and all. I hope you have a good rest of your night, and I will see you tomorrow. Peace. Bye.